Hello everyone, Little Muto here, and today I got another review for you guys. See on today's review, I'm going over the Fusion series, Godzilla 1968. So yeah, without further ado, let's go right into detail. Detail on this figure looks great. He's missed the same mold of a different paint scheme. And the detail on him looks good. The eyebrow is nice and sharp. You can see the snout. The eyes look good. The only downside I have with this figure was the mouth. We'll talk about that later. Teeth are a little sculpted. You can't even see the bottom, but you can't see the upper bow all that well. The neck looks good. Yeah, the arms look good. Same thing with the claws and the hands, they look nice and detailed. Even the chest and the stomach looks nice and detailed. You see all the spark respects to that the body here. Yep. Still on the legs look nice, even on the knees they look nice. Even the feet look good. The feet looks good on this figure. Bottom of the feet look good. Again, you see the sparkles. Even on the bottom of the feet, you see all the sparkles there. And also the tail looks good. The tail looks nicely done, but it's too short. There's the bottom of the tail. Looks good. Now for the back. Yeah, the back of the neck looks good. The spines are nice and detailed. They look a lot better than they did on the regular Panacreation version. Even the tail looks good. The spines on the tail look good. Now for paint job. This cast out of a translucent clear vinyl. His eyes are really nice painted in the white, the black with the irises and the white pupils. But the only downside I have is finger, look in the mouth. His mouth is way too pink, it's a bright pink. Yeah, see? His mouth is way too pink. That's the only downside I have with this figure. His mouth was way too pink. Yeah, the claws are nicely well painted. And yeah, it's a little bit of spray paint on his claws. Even on the stomach here is nicely good. It's nicely well done. And then he's really nicely well painted. The knees, see a little bit of white highlights here. Yep, the feet are nicely painted, the claws have nice detailed paint. Even the back has that black, you know, see? His spines are much painted better than they are on the normal Panacreation figure. Let's take a look at here in a second. And he's a really well done figure. Here's the tail. Yeah, it's the same as the Panacreation version. Now, before we go into articulation, I want to show you guys a side-by-side comparison with the Fusion Godzilla 68 and the normal Godzilla 1968 with a side-by-side comparison. One thing you're going to notice is the mouse here on the two. See, here's that paint color above the Fusion. The Fusion figure has a much brighter paint job in the mouth. As you can see, two figures are totally different. Yeah, he's translucent, you know, sparkles back, so he was not so much. But however, the spines here on his back are painted different colors. You see how his don't go all the way, the black doesn't go all the way up. Well, look at this one, the black goes all the way up to the tips there. That's how it should be. And the tails are the same. kind of dumb. Yeah, that's the side by side comparison with the regular Bandai Creation figure. Now I'll show you what it looks like next to the Bandai Japan Purple Tag Godzilla 1968. And again, they have two little green schemes in their mouths. The spines are different, and the tails are different. Here's the shorter and here's the correct length. Now go check out my review on the Purple Tag Godzilla 1968 and my review on the Bandai Creations Godzilla 1968. Now, for articulation and arms move and the legs move. And that's 4 points. His tail is a glue seal. I'm telling you, not like bringing this because we got soft vinyl. Yeah, you don't want to break the glue seal, so I recommend leaving the glue seal alone. Yeah, this thing is soft vinyl. Yeah, we haven't beeped in and out. But this figure didn't came with a normal figure. Now, before I show you what it looks like compared to other figures, here's the box. Like some of my other reviews, the box is the same here. Then we got the Bandai logo, Bandai.com, ages 4 and up. On the side has Godzilla's name in Japanese. There's the one in Shogun hazards. We have the Final Wars title. There's the Fusion Series sticker. There's one side of the box. It shows Godzilla and Gigan falling out. Other side, same thing. Here's the back, we have Godzilla 1968, Millennium Godzilla, and Gigan. I have all three of them. Now let's show you how it looks like in the box. That's what it looks like in this box. So yeah guys, now I'm going to show you guys the side-by-side comparison. Let's scale him with the pink tag, Godzilla 1954. This video, they look okay, but he's a little taller than him. Yeah. Now we'll scale him with Bandai Creations, first Godzilla. Yeah, he looks okay with the first Godzilla, so probably got a good scale with first Godzilla. Now let's try Bandai Creations Hedorah. Yeah, he looks good with Fedora 2, but I'm going to get a review for him. Now let's try the Bandai Creations Showa Gigan. Yeah, he looks good with the Showa Gigan here. So yeah, that's okay with Gigan. Now let's try the Bandai Creations Mechagodzilla. Yeah, he looks good with Mechagodzilla. He looks in good scale with Mechagodzilla here. Now scale with Bandai Creations, King Caesar. He looks good with King Caesar. And just for fun, let's scale him with Ella King. And he looks good with Ella King. See, who kind of in the scale for Showa Ella King. Now on to Verity. You can get this figure on my site, on Amazon or eBay. So yeah, I got other reviews on my other Fusion Series figures, so you can go check them out. Yeah, but the only Fusion Series figure I do not have is the Fusion Series Burning Godzilla. I don't have the Fusion Series Burning Godzilla. So yeah guys, that was my review on the Bandai Creations, Fusion Series, Godzilla 1968. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. As was Metal Muto, signing out.